Hi students, this is the third lecture on complex numbers, and today we will be having a detailed discussion on various forms of complex numbers. So let's get started. Complex numbers can be expressed in a number of different forms. Here are the various forms of a complex number that we will be dealing most of the time in our study of complex number. And these are Cartesian or rectangular form, Augen diagram or vector form, modulus augment form, and exponential form. Cartesian or rectangular form of a complex number z is given by z equals x plus yi, where x and y are real numbers. For example, the complex numbers z equals 3 plus 8i and z equals 5 minus 2i are written in their Cartesian form. So a Cartesian form expresses a complex number in terms of its real part and imaginary part. It is also called the general form of a complex number. As we discussed previously, that complex numbers can be geometrically represented by a two-dimensional diagram, which is called the complex plane. So every complex number inside this plane can be represented by a point. So let's consider the general complex number z equals x plus iy. We are going to plot this complex number inside the complex plane. So here is the complex plane. This is the real axis, the imaginary axis. Now, in order to plot this complex number, we consider a point inside this plane. So let's consider the point P with coordinates x and y. So here, this point P is the plot of this complex number. So here, x lies along the real axis, as it is the real part of the complex number, and y, being the imaginary part of the complex number, lies along the imaginary axis. Now, if we connect this point P with origin by a vector, then we get what we call an Augen diagram of the complex number. So, the Augen diagram of a complex number expresses a complex number in the form of a vector inside the complex plane. Let's have an example. Express the complex number z equals minus 4 minus 5i by an Augen diagram. So here we first of all consider the complex plane. Here the real part of the complex number is negative 4 and the imaginary part is negative 5. So we take negative 4 along the real axis and negative 5 along the imaginary axis, and we get the point with coordinates negative 4 and negative 5. So this point represents the given complex number inside this complex plane. And if we connect this point with origin by a vector like this, then we get the Augen diagram of the complex number minus 4 minus 5i. Before we introduce the modulus augment form or polar form of the complex number, let us first define what modulus and augment of a complex number are. The modulus of a complex number z equals x plus iy is the magnitude of the vector xy. So this means that if we consider the Augen diagram of the complex number, which expresses it in the form of a vector, then the magnitude of this vector represents the modulus of the complex number. Now, here the magnitude of the vector OP is given by the square root of x squared plus y squared. Hence, the modulus of the complex number z equals x plus iy is square root of x squared plus y squared. The argument of a complex number z equals x plus iy is the angle theta that its position vector makes with the positive real axis. So if we consider the organ diagram of the complex number, then the angle theta that this position vector makes with the positive real axis is known as the argument of the complex number. So this angle is always taken from the positive real axis and it lies in the interval from minus pi to pi. Now let's talk about the significance of this interval in which the argument theta lies. So it is negative from minus pi to 0 and positive from 0 to pi. So theta is positive in the first and second quadrants and it is negative in the third and fourth quadrants. Since theta is always taken from the positive x-axis, so it is positive in the first and second quadrants because it is taken anticlockwise over here from positive x-axis. And in the third and fourth quadrant, theta is negative because here it is taken clockwise from positive x-axis. So theta is always positive above the x-axis or real axis and it is negative below the x-axis. Now let's have a look on a worked example where we find the modulus and argument of some complex numbers. Find the modulus and argument of each of the following complex numbers. So we start with the very first complex number, that is 5 plus 12i. So it is always better approach to consider the organ diagram of a complex number while solving for modulus and argument. So the organ diagram of complex number 5 plus 12i is over here. So here we represent the complex number 5 plus 12y by this point over here with coordinates 5, 12. So here we can use trigonometry to find the modulus and argument, which is this angle over here. So here the modulus of this complex number is just the length of this vector over here. To find the length of this vector, we can use Pythagoras theorem over here. So the length of the vector is, which is the modulus. So this is square root of 5 squared plus 12 squared, which is square root of 169, which is equal to 13. So the modulus of complex number 5 plus 12i is 13 over here. Now the argument of the complex number 5 plus 12i is simply this angle theta over here. So we can find this angle by using trigonometry by taking tangent of this angle. So here tan theta equals 12 over 5 and we can solve for theta over here to find the argument. So here the argument of 5 plus 12i is equal to theta, which is simply the tan inverse of 12 over 5, which is 1.18, correct to 3 significant figures. Now we find the modulus and argument of the complex number minus 3 plus 4i. So again we consider its organ diagram over here. So here our complex number, as you can see over here, is in the second quadrant. So the modulus of this complex number is the length of this vector over here, which we can find by Pythagoras theorem again. So the modulus of minus 3 plus 4i is square root of negative 3 squared plus 4 squared, which is equal to square root of 25, which is 5. So the modulus of minus 3 plus 4i is 5. Now we find its argument. So here the argument of minus 3 plus 4i is equal to the angle theta. So we have to find this angle theta, which is anticlockwise with positive x-axis. Now, as you can see over here, there is another angle that we have named alpha over here. So this is an acute angle. So we can find our required angle theta by subtracting this acute angle from pi. So theta will be equal to pi minus alpha. So alpha is our acute angle, which is equal to tan inverse of 4 by 3. So acute angle can be found by this tan inverse of 4 over 3. So our angle theta will be equal to pi minus this acute angle. So pi minus tan inverse of 4 over 3, which simplifies to 2.21, correct to 3 significant figures. Now we find the modulus and argument of the complex number 12 minus 5i. Again, we consider its Argand diagram. So we have a sketch of its Argand diagram over here. So this complex number is represented by the point with coordinates 12 and negative 5, which lies in the fourth quadrant. So to find the modulus, we find the length of this vector, which is the position vector for the complex number 12 minus 5i. So the length of this vector, or the modulus of the complex number, is square root of 12 squared plus negative 5 squared, which is equal to square root of 169, which is equal to 13. Now we find its argument. So argument of 12 minus 5i is equal to theta. So here, as you can see, theta lies in the fourth quadrant. So theta is negative over here because it is measured with positive x-axis. So it is in clockwise direction over here. So this is negative. So theta is equal to the acute angle in measure, but it is negative. So here, theta is equal to negative acute angle. An acute angle over here is tan inverse of 5 over 12. So theta is equal to negative tan inverse of 5 over 12, which is equal to negative 0.395, correct to 3 significant figures. Now we find the modulus and argument of the complex number minus 4 minus 3i. So let's have a sketch of its Argand diagram. So this complex number is represented by a point which lies in the third quadrant with coordinates negative 4 and negative 3. So the modulus of minus 4 minus 3i is simply the length of its position vector over here. So the modulus of minus 4 minus 3i is equal to square root of minus 4 squared plus minus 3 squared, which is equal to square root of 25, which is equal to 5. Let's find out its argument. So the argument of minus 4 minus 3i is equal to theta. So here theta again lies below the real axis, so it is going to be negative. But first we find theta. So theta can be found by subtracting this acute angle alpha from pi. So theta is equal to pi minus alpha. So pi minus, so now the acute angle alpha can be found by taking tan inverse of 3 over 4. So theta is equal to pi minus tan inverse of 3 over 4, which is equal to 2.50, correct to 3 significant figures. But the important thing here is that theta should be negative here because it lies below the real axis and it is in clockwise direction with positive x-axis. So our final answer, which is the argument, so theta will be equal to negative 2.50. Now, after learning to find modulus and argument of a complex number, now we can introduce modulus argument form or polar form of a complex number. So let's consider the Argand diagram for the general complex number z equals x plus iy. So this complex number here is represented by a point P with coordinates x and y inside this complex plane. Now if we connect the point P with origin by a vector, which is the vector OP here, so this vector is called the position vector of the complex number. And the length of this vector gives the magnitude or modulus of the complex number. And the angle theta that this vector makes with positive real axis is known as the argument of the complex number. So let's denote the length of this vector or the magnitude or the modulus of the complex number by r over here. And then we can use trigonometry to get cos theta equals x over r, which is adjacent over hypotenuse, and sin theta is equal to y over r, which is opposite over hypotenuse. And if we solve for x and y from here, we get x equals r cos theta and y equals r sin theta. And if we substitute these values of x and y into the general form over here, so if we replace x with r cos theta and y with r sin theta over here, then we get z equals r cos theta plus I r sin theta. So here we have replaced this x with r cos theta and y with r sin theta. And if we take r common from these two terms, we get z equals r times cos theta plus I sin theta. And this form is known as the modulus argument form of the complex number z equals x plus iy. Since the modulus argument form of a complex number z equals x plus iy is given by z equals r times cos theta plus I sin theta, where r is the modulus of the complex number z and theta is the argument of z. So this means that we can easily write the modulus argument form of a complex number if we know its modulus and its argument. Here, r and theta are called the polar coordinates of the point x and y. So with reference to these polar coordinates, so this form is also called the polar form of the complex number z equals x plus iy. So z equals r times cos theta plus I sin theta is modulus argument form or the polar form of the complex number. The exponential form of a complex number is kind of similar to the modulus argument form. The modulus argument form of a complex number is given by z equals r times cos theta plus I sin theta. So we can convert this form into exponential form by using a famous relationship which was discovered by Euler. And that relationship is cos theta plus I sin theta equals e to the power I theta. So if we replace cos theta plus I sine theta in the modulus argument form by e to the power I theta, then we get z equals r e to the power I theta. And this is what we call the exponential form of the complex number. So in order to find both modulus argument form and exponential form, what we require is the modulus of the complex number as well as its argument. Now let's consider a worked example on finding the modulus argument form and exponential form of a complex number. Z1 equals 1 plus I. So write Z1 in modulus argument form and exponential form. So here we first of all take the argand diagram for the complex number 1 plus I. So this is our complex number being represented by the point with coordinates 1, 1 inside the complex plane. So here the magnitude of this vector gives the modulus of the complex number. Hence the modulus R1 of complex number Z1 is equal to square root of 1 squared plus 1 squared, which is equal to square root of 2. And here theta 1 is the argument of this complex number. So theta 1 is equal to argument of 1 plus I, and this can be found by taking tan inverse of 1 over 1, which is equal to pi over 4. So we have found the modulus and argument. Now as we know, the modulus argument form of the complex number Z1 will be equal to R1 times cos theta 1 plus I sine theta 1. So we replace R1 and theta 1 by their values and we get Z1 equals square root of 2 times cos pi by 4 plus I sine of pi by 4, which is the required modulus argument form. And as we know, the exponential form of the complex number Z1 will be equal to R1 times e to the power I theta 1. And again, we replace R1 and theta 1 with their values to get theta 1 equals square root of 2 e to the power I times pi by 4, which is the exponential form of the complex number. So this is exponential form and this is the modulus argument form. Now we will study modulus argument form and exponential form of product of two complex numbers. Suppose we have two complex numbers Z1 and Z2, both expressed in their exponential forms. So here Z1 is equal to R1 e to the power I theta 1 and Z2 is equal to R2 e to the power I theta 2. So here the modulus of Z1 is R1 and argument of Z1 is theta 1. Similarly, the modulus of Z2 is R2 and argument of Z2 is theta 2. So suppose we have to find the product of Z1 and Z2. So Z1 times Z2 is equal to, so here we will multiply both Z1 and Z2 in their exponential forms. So we get R1 e to the power I theta 1 times R2 e to the power I theta 2. So now we can use the law of indices here to get R1 R2 e to the power I theta 1 plus I theta 2. So here we have added the powers I theta 1 and I theta 2 using the law of indices. Hence Z1 Z2 is equal to R1 R2 e to the power I times theta 1 plus theta 2. Here we have taken I common from I theta 1 plus I theta 2. So from here you can see that the modulus of Z1 times Z2 is R1 R2 and its argument is theta 1 plus theta 2. Similarly, we can write this exponential form in modulus argument form like Z1 Z2 is equal to R1 R2 cos of theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I sine of theta 1 plus theta 2. So here the modulus of Z1 times Z2, which is the modulus of product of Z1 and Z2, is equal to R1 R2. So here the modulus of this is R1 R2, which is equal to Z1 mod times Z2 mod. Similarly, the argument of Z1 Z2 is theta1 plus theta2. So argument of Z1 times Z2 is theta1 plus theta2. So this means that to multiply two complex numbers, we multiply their moduli and add their arguments. So when we find the product of two complex numbers and we want to express their exponential form and modulus argument form, then we multiply their moduli and we add their arguments. Now let's talk about modulus argument form and exponential form of quotient of two complex numbers. Suppose we have two complex numbers, Z1 and Z2, both expressed in their exponential forms. And here, Z1 is equal to R1 e to the power I theta 1 and Z2 is equal to R2 e to the power I theta 2. Here, modulus of Z1 is R1 and argument of Z1 is theta 1. Similarly, the modulus of Z2 is R2 and argument of Z2 is theta 2. Now we are interested in finding the quotient Z1 over Z2, which is equal to R1 e to the power I theta 1 over R2 e to the power I theta 2. So here we again use the law of indices to get R1 over R2 e to the power I theta 1 minus I theta 2. So here we subtract the lower power from the upper power using the law of indices. Hence Z1 over Z2 is equal to R1 over R2 e to the power I times theta 1 minus theta 2, which is the exponential form of Z1 over Z2, which can be written in modulus argument form as Z1 over Z2 is equal to R1 over R2 cos theta 1 minus theta 2 plus I sine of theta 1 minus theta 2. So from both of these two forms, exponential form and modulus argument form, we can see that modulus of Z1 over Z2 is R1 over R2, which is equal to Z1 mod over Z2 mod, and argument of Z1 over Z2 is theta 1 minus theta 2. So argument of Z1 over Z2 is equal to theta 1 minus theta 2. So to divide two complex numbers, we divide their moduli and subtract their arguments. So when we have to find the quotient or ratio of two complex numbers, we divide their moduli and subtract their arguments. Now let's consider a worked example. The complex numbers u and v are given by u equals 9 plus 12i and v equals minus 5 minus 3i. Find the modulus and argument of uv, which is u times v, and u over v. So first of all, we consider the Argand diagram of the complex number u equals 9 plus 12y. So this complex number is represented by the point with coordinates 9 and 12 inside this complex plane. Hence, the modulus of u is equal to square root of 9 squared plus 12 squared, which is equal to square root of 225, which is equal to 15. And the argument of u is this angle theta over here, which is equal to tan inverse of 12 over 9, which is equal to 0.927. Now the modulus argument form for the complex number v, which is minus 5 minus 3i, is over here. So here this complex number is being represented by a point inside the third quadrant with coordinates negative 5 and negative 3. So modulus of v is negative 5 squared plus negative 3 squared, which is equal to square root of 34. And argument of v is theta. And theta can be found by subtracting this acute angle alpha from pi. Since the complex number lies in third quadrant, so the angle which is the argument is going to be negative. So the argument of V is negative pi minus alpha, which is minus pi plus alpha, which is equal to minus pi plus 10 inverse of 3 over 5, because here alpha is equal to 10 inverse of 3 over 5. So argument of V is equal to minus 2.60. So we have found the moduli and arguments of both of the given two complex numbers. Now the modulus of U times V, as we already know, is equal to modulus of U times modulus of V, which is 15 times square root of 34. And argument of U times V will be equal to argument of U plus argument of V. And argument of U was 0.927 plus, and argument of V was minus 2.60, which simplifies to minus 1.67. And modulus of U over V is modulus of U over modulus of V, which is 15 over square root of 34. And argument of U over V is argument of U minus argument of V, which is 0.927 minus minus 2.60, which is equal to 3.528. So as you can see here, to find the modulus of the product of U and V, we have multiplied their moduli, and to find the argument of the product of U and V, we have added their arguments. And in finding the modulus of their quotient, we have taken the quotient of their moduli, and to find the argument of their quotient, we subtract their arguments. Dear students, with this we come to the end of today's lesson. I hope this has helped you in your study of complex numbers. And in the next lesson, we will focus on complex numbers as solution of polynomial equations. So we will see how complex numbers arise as solution of polynomial equations. So until next time, take care.